deciding to cut my hair, basically, when I got the part, I thought, how are we going to do Fontaine's hair cutting scene? That seems, that's going to be really impossible. It happens within a song, so I never leave the stage. And there's literally a few bars of music for me to go from having long, beautiful locks to a completely shorn head. So I thought, well, would it be easier if I had short hair underneath my wig? You know, maybe that's the way to go. So I offered that to David, and initially he and everybody else just seemed like, oh no, we'll find another way for you to do this so you don't have to cut your hair. And I thought, okay, all right. So I kind of gave up on the whole idea of having to cut my hair at all. And then one day at rehearsal, like in the middle of rehearsal, this is what cracks me up. So David, in the middle of rehearsal, he's like, man, by the way, are you still interested in cutting your hair? And he's like, so there's, you know, we've been thinking about it. We just think that might be easier. I think without knowing it, I went from standing to sitting. and he told me, he said, it's absolutely your choice, but Andre and I were thinking if you cut your hair, you could possibly donate it. And that, I don't know, that just stuck with me. I was like, oh. You know, that means it's not about me, it's not just about these two weekends of performances that I need to figure out, you know, and decide whether it's really worth it to chop all my hair off and live with short hair for a long time for two weekends. No, I'd actually be giving up my hair for to lots of love, and that just made my decision for me. I was like, yeah, okay, I can do that. Whoa, it's starting to get really short. And, okay, sorry, I'm tripping out on my incredibly short hair on this side here.